Shabbat Shalom and welcome. I'm Rivka the Jade Gamer, and this is Warhammer 40K Rogue Trader Episode 5. I know last time I had it listed as Episode 5, but it was really Episode 4. And we're beginning Chapter 2. So with Chapter 2, I am also beginning my path on my second career. I think I'm going to go with Assassin. There we go. Inflict Despair. And then Logic. Let's do Foreboding. Let's see. Psi rating 1. All right, Psychic Barrage. But I think I want to do Pain Channeling and Willpower. Perception here. And Hymn of Hatred. No, Eternal Glory. Destined. Yes, Destined. I like Destined. All right, let's apply that. Now here, let's say Bounty Hunter. One rank available. Okay. All right, two archetypes. And we're going to go with Vanguard. Alright, and let's give you Arch-Militant. And then two archetypes, you are going to be Vanguard. And you. So, I want to talk to all my crew. Well, not all of the crew, the important crew members, such as Argenta. How did you end up on Theodora's ship? And this mistake of yours. I just noticed something. I want application audio capture.
During the last journey,
Here we
Senator
go.
Sarian stood out for me. He came by several times to ask about my health. He's an honorable man and a loyal servant of the Imperium. I think he is as meticulous in his inspections of the logistics systems as he is in his inquiries about the health of the occasional sister of battle aboard the ship. But not all of Theodora's people have earned my trust. You know who I'm talking about. There is no place for Adira Tlas among the God Emperor's faithful. I'm surprised she wasn't in league with the pirates. And I'm equally surprised by how deep heresy and treason run in this place. I'm glad we all made it through that dark hour. May the day that follows be bright.
So the people who wounded you.
Sadly, they did not. Lady Theodora was in a hurry and chose not to stay on the planet. Her people took me to a ship while I was unconscious, and when I came to my senses, we were already flying away. How I pray to come face to face with those heretics once more, and it's bound to happen someday.
And where did this happen?
On one of the recently discovered planets in the expanse. No one suspected that it had already been tainted by the filth of heresy. Had I known it beforehand, of course I would have been on my guard.
Shall we?
The path to that planet was lost. All the knowledge is gone, along with the previous navigator. It would take immense effort and resources to rediscover the route. The heir to the Von Valancy's protectorate must have plenty of other issues to deal with right now. Perhaps perhaps later, when the skies above our heads have cleared.
Alright, well, thank you very much for answering my questions.
Words cannot describe how boring the bridge is without our stimulating conversations.
Well, tell me about yourself.
I am a part of House Orselio, an ancient dynasty of the Navis Nobilitae. Since time immemorial, our family has served to advance knowledge, pushing at the boundaries of the dark unknown. The Starway Atlas contains 2,843 routes that chart the sectors of the Segmentum Obscurus and reach all the way from the Coronis Expanse to Holy Terra, and uniting the Imperium's thousands of worlds. House Orselio is bound by commercial pacts to houses Galliatis, Ortina, Drotus, and... There is a dark blue knot tightening on your neck, Lord Captain. I can see my reply is not satisfying your thirst for knowledge. What is it you desire to hear, exactly?
Sorry, Cassia, but I would like to know more about you personally, not your family.
You wish to know about me?
Yeah. Tell me what your life was like on the station.
My stay on the station was wholly dedicated to preparing me for my future duties. Astromancy, astrography, numerology, the histories of my house and the Imperium, as well as other disciplines. For many years, dozens of instructors tirelessly prepared me for my destiny. And once a year, Great Regent Alronto would come to the station. He would entrust his beautiful vessel to my command, so that I could master the practical aspects of our art as well.
And you never lived anywhere other than Uruk 5?
Hardly. According to the chronicles of the house, I was born on one of the Orselio worlds. Please forgive me, Lord Captain. My childhood memories are too vague. Sometimes I dream about the colorful birds that built their nests in the garden, or the servants dressed in purple livery, or the blue fog that rolled over the lowlands behind the palace. But everything is covered in a rosy haze. Perhaps it is my imagination, not my memory, that is painting these pictures.
Did you not have friends?
Were too respectful of my duty to my house to waste precious time on idle chatter. Aside from them, there were only servants on the station, and you know they have their vocal cords removed, so they cannot break their vow of silence. And since the subject has been breached, Lord Captain, why do you not follow this honored tradition? Your decks are so garish. Apologies, I meant noisy. The rabble don't just chatter. Sometimes they shout and even sing. Why do you allow such a lack of restraint? Rogue traders are highborn, are they not?
I like the noise people make here. It fills the ship with life.
With life? Oh, if only you could take my place and watch this kaleidoscope. Every voice is a flash of color. Every conversation a shimmering glow. Every argument is an unstoppable swirl of gaudy splotches.
I can understand. Do you always conceal your third eye?
The navigator's open eye is baneful to whoever the warp's ruinous shine falls upon, and therefore it is the symbol of our power. We are the guiding stars of humanity, found worthy of an uncommon gift. And one of the duties that we bear is to guard our eye, even from wayward glances that may bear evil. Besides, I am aware that lesser
the servants of the Imperium may find our appearance repulsive. The Navigator gene twists the features the rabble are used to seeing, and the magnificence of our role cannot be grasped by their feeble minds.
You are beautiful, Cassia. Do not let anyone or anything convince you otherwise.
You are much too kind to me, Lord Captain. Allow me, for my part, to note the beauty of your shoulders? Yes, your shoulders. Pray let us change the subject.
Alright. What does it feel like to guide a vessel through the warp?
Tried to follow his example, but the wood would not reveal itself to me. But everything changed when I found my own key to this mystery. You see, I've always brightened up my rare moments of leisure time by painting. You may recall there was a workshop in my chambers. As soon as I imagined the warp as a blank canvas, an indescribable feeling came over me. I moved the brush, going deeper and deeper into my own painting. Visions were hidden within the vibrant colors of my palette, and something inside me knew which should be brought out and which should be left behind. I woke up several days later, after the voyage was safely complete.
I notice that your love of painting is reflected in your speech as well. You associate so many things with images and hues.
The Emperor graced me with a gift. I can see inner life in addition to the mundane. You cannot know that a fruit has
rotten
from the inside until a blade slices it in two.
Bye, Mischief.
I can see the rot from far away. It roils like swamp mud, oozing through the bright peel. Anger and boredom, sadness and joy. Everything that people shut away inside themselves is revealed to me like colors on the canvas of my world.
Why don't we speak of something else?
You will hear no objection from me, Lord Captain.
What does your special sight reveal?
Sister Argenta shines like a guiding star, inspiring resolve in those around her, seemingly inexplicably. However, I see a dark and ugly fog billow behind her, contrasting sharply with her shining light. It burdens the Sister of Battle. It drags her down. Yet Argenta herself is hardly aware of it. Seneschal Viserion is among the few whose colors are a pleasure to look at. Whenever the Seneschal speaks, heavenly crystal clarity spreads around him. And whenever he is angered, dark blue clouds condense over him, and in his rare moments of joy, a pure gleam of sunset pink caresses the souls of those near him. Out of your entire retinue, Lord Captain, he is the only one I would trust with my life. The esteemed Magus Hanuman is shattered like a beautiful stained glass window into a mosaic of colors. His bright, beckoning hues are mixed together in complete disarray. I must confess, it perplexes me. Normally, scarlet and steel are all that fills the heart of a servant of the Omnissiah. Behind the cobalt steel of his thoughts, behind the cold, faded gray of his emotions, an ember, the color of amber, glows in Master Van Kalox's soul. So bright and warm, one is tempted to touch it. It is sad that the interrogator seeks to drown it with his own hands in the bottomless blue of duty. Sad indeed, but I can relate.
Okay.
Adira's emotions are like a maelstrom, bright, unbridled, enveloping her form like a wondrous kaleidoscope of colors. and as dangerous as a twisting warp storm. The riot of colors hides the truth from my eyes. What exactly is driving this woman? Is it her own will, or is it the Immaterium, Lord Captain?
Alright, tell me about your house.
As the only voice of our family on this vessel, it is an honor. As long as your questions are courteous, I will answer every one of them.
Is your Celio prophecy system named after your ancestor?
You are shrewd indeed. My ancestor charted that route while fleeing the enemies of humanity. They say the Emperor himself was his guide, because the warp expelled their vessel without a single loss. Unfortunately, the lips of those who relate this tale seep with disgusting green hubris. I think Kaline Orselio was simply a skilled navigator.
And I take it your house has a rich history.
Oh, yes.
Hey, how are you doing, Dizzy? Shabbat shalom and welcome. I'm doing well, and you?
Just as a rogue trader stands at the head of a protectorate, a Novator heads a navigator house. It is the Novator who decides where to look for alliances and which path their bloodline is destined to tread.
I like brownies.
After our house, the transfer of power to a successor is currently underway. In the meantime, Great Regent Auronto Orselio is ensuring the stability of the house. Regent Auronto. Nothing is decided yet. Some people in the house become enshrouded in rolling gray clouds at the thought of me becoming the Novator. But even more are bound with dull leaden chains. They think I am not ready for such a burden.
With your permission, let's speak of something else. Actually, I'll be back. And thank you. All right, Abelard. Let's speak of things that may be useful to me as the rogue trader.
A noble aspiration, Lord Captain. I am ready to acquaint you with all the particulars that interest you.
What is the situation in the Cronus Expanse?
This is a topic for an official briefing, not a casual conversation. But I will try to answer succinctly. And if you permit, in my own words. The Cronus Expanse is considerably warp routes become useless within months. Established pathways are regularly subject to attacks from all kinds of ravens.
I have to say that is impressive.
Imperium's frigates find themselves moored alongside pirate vessels. Until recently, the Cronus Expanse could hardly have been called a region of the Imperium. The situation has changed with the arrival of the Lord Inquisitor, but not by much. This place operates under its own rules, you see. More radical, so to speak. But ones that allow for a non-standard approach where there is a promise of victory. The Cronus Expanse is considered rogue trader territory for a reason. Only rogue traders have sufficient...
I'm sure that makes it more difficult.
...and the rights granted them by the warrant to survive the leap into the unexplored part of the Expanse. And in the event of a successful outcome, to hold on to whatever they manage to capture on the frontier.
So, who are the major players?
In the first instance, you should treat official representatives of the Imperium with respect. The Expanse may be on the fringes, but it still numbers among the territories of the Golden Throne. The arrival of the Lord Inquisitor has turned the Cronus Expanse into a less wild and uncontrolled region, to the regret of some individuals who had grown inured to the local lawlessness. Rogue traders such as yourself are also servants of the Imperium. They have been accorded special rights and powers. They wield immense authority within their territory, and they enjoy absolute respect in other parts of the Expanse. The most powerful of them are Kalagos Winterscale and Incendia Bastal Chorda. Tread carefully when dealing with either of them.
All right.
If we are to speak of unclaimed territory, which is what Footfall is, among the scum that dwells on that handful of asteroids, there are three factions that wield considerable influence in the sector. The first is the Kazbala Commission, organized crime in its most primitive form. It holds sway over the Liege of Footfall and has links to rogue trader Winterscale. The second faction is an offshoot of our shining Ecclesiarchy, followers of St. Drusus. They are actively building their forces and hold influence over rogue trader Chorda. And finally, the third faction, the Exploratores, a wing of the Adeptus Mechanicus. They are willing to die and kill for the secrets of the ancient technological heresies that are hidden among the stars of the Coronus Expanse.
And what do you think that Conrad will do next?
You know, Lord Captain, I am no admirer of fine art. But when we next find ourselves in a civilized port with time to spare, I will promptly find an artist and commission a portrait of the individual to whom you refer, with a hole between the eyes. Conrad Voitvere. That he committed his treachery and escaped with his life was an unforgivable oversight. We both served Lord Captain Theodora for many years, and we never saw eye to eye. He was brash. He was never afraid of assuming responsibility, and he willingly took on difficult tasks. I am loath to admit it, but the Von Valancius Protectorate continues to reap the fruits of his labors to this day. His service always garnered my respect. But everything else about him made me want to wring the neck of that two-faced snake. If you are taking comfort in the thought that we will hear no more of Conrad, prepare to be disappointed. You thwarted his plans, his meticulously plotted and nurtured treachery. He is sure to attempt a strike at you, and he will use his contacts and knowledge of the Protectorate to do so. The only question, Lord Captain, is whether you will be able to anticipate his next steps.
All right, that's all for now.
As you wish, Lord Captain.
I'll speak with you later.
Lord Captain.
Adira, let us speak. You seem to have a strong reaction to what Argenta said by the broken lens.
It was just my nerves playing up. Something about our little saint doesn't sit right with me, and I trust my gut. Oh, sure, she seems straight as an arrow and as predictable as a hangover after drinking. But when I look at her, something about her makes my brain itch. After that conversation, I tried to listen to what was being said about her beyond the door. What I heard was strange. Blood in her past, twilight in her present, and something like a star leading her. But where is it leading her? I saw several roads, and all of them frightened me.
What do you think it means?
If I knew, I would have told you. Hearing things clearly requires cooperation from the other person, you know. But that cobra just hisses and spits its venom at me. I don't trust her one bit.
Do you think we should warn her?
Pointless. anyway? I'm not even sure what it all means. Maybe the danger is to her? Or maybe the danger's coming from her.
So where do you come from?
Lyra, an outlying world in the Heathen Stars region. In the Coronis Expanse, the deeper you go, the less visible the
atmosphere. Hey, welcome! Shabbat Shalom, Nova.
The arrival of a rogue trader is the best thing that can happen to a world like that. The very best.
Tell me about Lyra. Ooh.
I haven't been there in many years, but there's nothing for me to miss. Trust me.
Space is a vacuum.
But here on the ship is a different story altogether. I saw more wonders in my first year serving Lady von Valancius than I'd seen in my whole life on Lyra. Like my first journey through the warp, I was in bed for 3 days. I felt like supernovas were exploding in my head. I only found out later that I'd gotten off easy. Just through the bulkhead in the bay next to mine, a whole team turned into... Look at me rambling on, Lord Captain. Pay no attention.
So what did you do before you came here?
Oh, I embroidered wall hangings in honor of our national heroes. I did the same thing I do here, Lord. Divining. Our rulers prized the ability to see into the future. Every psyker that could be found was worth a small fortune on Lyra. There's no such thing as a peaceful life on Lyra. People like me were especially sought after. They'd pick psykers up wherever they found them, buy kids off their parents, even just abduct them. Take me, for instance. I got taken from my street gang. The older kids sold me when they noticed there was something off about me. The ruling dynasties had schools where they trained us and beat us black and blue. And then they packed us off to serve. Some of us held on for a long time, but others didn't last. Not everyone's as smart and talented as me, you know. Some people crossed the line and were out of commission before their time.
Ooh. I haven't actually looked at anything Lethal Company. And I haven't played Last of Us.
Theodora von Valancius paid a visit to the ruler I was serving at the time. I don't know what the visit was for, and it's no business of mine anyway. I can still remember the way the voices in my head changed when I looked at her. They were practically screaming. She had so much behind her, and plenty ahead of her, too. As I looked at her, all of a sudden I heard a whisper, a hint, a suggestion, nothing more. But I know the difference between idle chatter and a real threat. I seized my chance and approached Theodora. I managed to whisper a couple of words in her ear before the wardens dragged me away. They beat me and locked me up. No wonder. It wasn't my place to converse with outsiders. And then Theodora's people came for me. They broke down the wall, butchered the guards. Also, I could tell them my warning in full. So I said the rest, but I didn't want to go back to my old life. And so I entered the service of the von Valancius dynasty. A few times. Not many. And if I think about it, why would I want to? I've got everything I need here. All the whispers I hear are familiar ones. They almost feel like family. And if I want to hear about the nightmares off the ship, I can. After some Amisek. But don't go getting the wrong idea. If I have to, I'll follow you to the edge of the galaxy.
You never finished your first story about crossing the warp.
It wasn't like it was a very fun trip, Lord Captain. But look, if you want to be entertained, I'm the woman for the job. I'll entertain you with one of the stories from my collection, no problem. But if you want to hear about the time I melted everyone in the bay next door, well, I just don't really want to go into the details on that one, all right?
That's fine. Let's speak of something else. Actually, I must take my leave.
Of course.
Let's take a look at the map. Unknown ships, there's Footfall, and a dead world. Lord Captain, I'm getting reports of several ships moving toward us. Judging by the fact that they're not responding to our hails, and telemetry shows a trail of microbatteries, they're not here for chinwag. Ready to issue orders to prepare for the battle at your command. Can we evade? I don't think so, Lord Captain. There'd be no reason to. It'd be easier to blast these scum smithereens than to just evade them. We'll warn Footfall we're coming with a few microsalvos. Alright, on my order. All stations get ready for void combat. Okay. Okay. All right. All right. You know what this reminds me of? The X-Wing miniatures game. let's go to here. There. And let's hit it with that. So, the X-Wing miniatures game, you have a dial that shows what your ship's movement is. And it has to move each time. And so the dial just tells you which template you're going to use for movement. So let's see. Shoot with that. Go to here. Alright, let's see there. Alright, let's go to here. I'm fairly certain there's a good tabletop simulator module of it. Okay. How could I miss you, Pascal? Okay. Upgrade the hole. Okay. Oh. Cool. Mess with Therix. Master of Maneuvers. Yes. Hole repair. Right. Lord Captain, the station's airlocks have been sealed from the inside. A Vox recording is stating that the priesthood of the Altar Templum Calixtus X-17 Sanctuary have no desire to communicate with the laity, and are refusing access to guests on the bridge of the Adeptus Mechanicus, privilege of inviolability, granting them sole jurisdiction over their sacred rites. All right, let's begin our scan. Lord Catton, we have the flagship Drusus Blessin with a small escort dead ahead. They're requesting a direct Vox channel, patching you through.
Greetings, Lord Captain. I'm honored to speak with the rogue trader of House von Valencius. May your name be known throughout the ages. Chartist Captain Austerius Thorfast, bearer of a free charter of the merchant fleet. How can I be of service?
Hey, what are y'all doing here? We develop supply routes from Chartists for Chartists. You see, my ship is a representative of the merchant fleet in this part of the Imperium territory. Yet we do not have a fixed charter-defined trade route. Our mission is to establish business contacts with void farers in need of regular ship repairs and those who are interested in specialized goods. All right, I'd like to take a look at what you have available. All right. I don't have anything that I can trade. Let's get this. So where do you source your materials? Are asking me to disclose our suppliers to you? Well, frankly, they come from both everywhere and nowhere. We get our wares from either lucky voidsmen who stumble upon an abandoned or dilapidated ship somewhere in a neighboring system, or from unlucky ones whose sorry tub arrives on footfall in such a state it's easier to take her apart than to restore her. Alright, well, how are the fleet's operations going? For the most part, all the Expanse has its fleets of different organizations and small flotilla of merchant ships. Uninterrupted communication between worlds is a matter of life and death for many outposts of humanity. So even in this dark corner of the Imperium, there are Chartists and ships assigned to the Adeptus, to the various Adeptus. Alas, the Expanse has next to no stable trade routes, so the job can be precarious at times. Then again, no one is more intimately familiar with the hardships of local commerce than a rogue trader. Alright. Let's check out Footfall. Your ladyship. Something sinister is unfolding among the survivors of Rykad Minoris. There have already been several cases of evacuated refugees being found either dead or dying. All of them have been blinded using various means. I fear there is reason to believe that there were agents of the cult among the people who came on board. I knew the anathema would not fully release its hold on those doleful souls just yet. Let us march and drive it away. How are they quartered? How are they supervised? The esteemed nobles and their families were given quarters befitting their status. The horrors of the massacre in the streets are still fresh in their minds. Initially, they made regular trips to the lower deck to take out their fears and anger on serfs from our own crew. It would have been disrespectful to confine the nobles to their compartments, so we used shackles of a different sort by generously supplying them with amisecan intoxicants. The venerated Praetor Electroid Dar Impulse 6 and his retinue took refuge in one of the engineering bays. Or, more accurately, they barricade themselves in. The wise servants of the Omnissiah are fearful beyond measure that ignorant laypeople might damage or offend their miraculous fusion reactor, so they cloistered themselves in their own personal fortress. Alright, so I need to know more about the killings. 11 bodies have been found thus far. The first victim had their eyes burned out with a gas torch. The second had acid splashed in their face. The third was found wandering around and on their last legs with a metal pin sticking out of their eye sockets. They died before we could interrogate them. The rest were killed and disfigured in similar ways, through blinding. No trace of the killer's identity were found. Let's begin the interrogations. It will be done, Your Ladyship. If I may, there is no need. The interrogations have already been conducted. I did put the enforcers on alert as soon as the first body was discovered. I decided not to disturb Your Ladyship until I had results. Well, now I do. We have already rested. Let's see. Four perpetrators at the scene of the crimes that had yet to take place. Those are not murders. They are suicides. Explain. The people we apprehended were about to blind themselves and end their own lives. I am confident that all who perished did the same. When questioned, they all said the same thing. They are haunted by the sight of the dying Rykad Minoris, even in their sleep. Yet they still see the same horrific picture. So the sad wretches would do anything to make the nightmare stops. Well, let's have cleansing liturgies on the decks housing the refugees. We shall banish this blight with the strength of our faith. Certainly, Lord Captain. Except, I am afraid, it's not just the refugees. 3 out of 4 people we arrested were members of the crew. They watched Rykad Minoris die, and it left their minds scarred. We all bear the mark of the catastrophe, for it was the attention of the Runeless Power that branded our very souls. May the God Emperor have mercy on us. You are warned, Your Ladyship. It is regrettable that you did not listen. All right. Your Ladyship, forgive me for not welcoming you with an appropriate obeisance. We were told you would prefer to arrive on footfall incognito, so we're trying to attract as little attention as possible. I'm here on behalf of the Leisure Footfall, Lord Vladeum Tokara. The Leisure waits a chance to speak with you at his residence, but if you happen to have other business to attend to, I can serve as your guide and tell you about the station. This looks so familiar. Behind the amber-colored scatterings of words of welcome, far less appealing dark hues lurk, murking deluded. Look of someone accustomed to lying and hiding their intentions. Something's coming, and they're coming for us. Watch out, Lord Captain. What's the situation on Footfall? There are certain problems, Your Ladyship, but Delicia can acquaint you with them far better than I. You really should talk to Leisure about this. I'm just... I love how they are willing to shoot themselves in the back. Let's see, analyze enemies, hunt down the prey.
They who discern the future on Was it you? Or...
Doubt is for the weak.
All right, we've done some shooting. Okay.
Pain and duty go hand in hand. Brace yourself, Abelard.
So let's go to here. Oh.
Indeed, reduce the dust.
There. Let's take this. That'll hit Abelard. I don't want to hit Abelard. All right, Pascal. All right, let's kill her.
How dare you?
All right.
Anything is? Not this Grayer's job. This is unacceptable. As the Emperor commands, I act. This is why I'm eradicated.
All right. Let's just go ahead and reload.
Don't you need a breathing navigator?
Because I... Let's see. Continue. Who's coming? Their strength is in their numbers. Let's put Pascal there. Shoot your own people in the back, go ahead. Yep, let's go ahead and... Let's do that. Let's do a psychic shriek to get rid of that person. There. So let's go here. Oh, wait. I want to do... that. All right. I want to...
Isn't this a job for the serfs?
Here, charge is at the fall. All right. Rapid fire, no. Concentrated fire.
Faith without deeds is worthless. As the Emperor commands, I act.
We're going to go here and do this. Adira, let's
what of course.
Ouch. Daring breach.
No matter the cost. I will do like you. It will be done. Victory is imminent.
And let's see how much damage we can do over here. Alright, let's reload. Killed a few of them. Good. Let's see.
Tomes of military tactics. Doubt is for the weak. Strike is a prayer. As the Emperor commands. I'll do it. Eradicated. As the Emperor commands, strike is a prayer.
Okay. Oh, that was convenient.
As the Emperor commands, strike is a prayer. I'll do it. As the Emperor commands, I act.
So let's go here and have you bring it down.
It will be done. Indeed. One viewer target.
I'm not a
will be done.
And dead. Protect me. They killed. Every time I warned them and they all go, dear Emperor, our Lord and Savior, how could this have happened? Who could have thought? Does this happen here often? Shooting, yes. Attacks on nobles, no. Unless it's the Anvers, they're vicious. Not a week goes by without them killing some
and cutting somebody, they're wicked heretics. They respect nothing. They follow no rules. Go and report this to your liege. Yes, I'm sorry, ladyship. I'll go report to the liege. They killed her. Oh, they killed my lady. Oh, this is terrible. Yes, I'm sure. Let's see, I do want that. Let's see. Anvers.
The world is full of colors I have never seen before.
Ooh. All right. All right, Ragman. All right. One, 6165. Let's go ahead and collect that. Commerce.
I did it. As it should be.
Bow to the Emperor through the Rug. Holy Book by the Altar. That void damn customs guy. Guess what? And hanger by the window. Interesting. God, citizens.
Okay.
I've read about this.
Oh, they're planning on killing me. Galvanic servo haulers. That is just beautiful. I have this model. Yeah, let's go to the atrium. I absolutely adore the beauty of this game. Imperium. Okay. Death World Light Flak. Cool. Is there anybody who wears medium? I'm not going to trade off your holy vestments. Medium. Less dodge penalty? Okay. Boots. Alright, so you've got the Skirmisher, Warmonger, Medal of Alacrity. All right, improved armored body glove. Hmm. Yeah, I like the charge staff more. Right, Rebel sniper rifle. All right. It's a regular sword. Drokhari barbed needles. I think I want the primitive. Put that there, and we'll give actually, I'm going to put that on. All right. All right.
Operation successful.
Use the conjugator. Logic.
My success is an irrefutable certainty. Nothing's impossible for this old officer.
All right. Okay. Excuse me. Collect all, thank you.
Knowledge is eternal.
Yeah, I just don't like these laying around.
Activating motive force reserves.
The Heart of Footfall. Let's go and speak with the Liege. My patience. You remember the way out? Dismissed. Let him. Why does he put such harsh words in your mouth? You talk like you're an Imperial cleric, not one of us. Where's my cargo, Vladame? Falco has, doesn't he? So that's how you do business with your friends these days.
So you don't remember.
Then the guards will remind you. Guards, escort her out.
Hedari, move. Jay, he's going to... Get going while he's letting you. Go drown your sorrows at the Amescus, and thank your lucky stars you were able to walk out the door. You won't get the chance next time.
First an insult, now threats. I see the courtesy and tact are no longer valued commodity on Footfall. Oh well, I'll find myself a better deal.
I'll give her a better deal.
Uladim Tokara, Leash of Footfall, let us proceed to my office. A spread befitting a visitor of your rank is waiting. Your entourage will be accommodated nearby. Certainly. Please, follow me. Let us talk business. On behalf of the elite of Footfall Station, I offer you my condolences, Lady Von Valencius. We mourn Lady Theodora's loss, and we hope this sentiment is taken as a sign of our good intentions and willingness to cooperate. Thank you, Liege. A terrible loss for all of us. I hope that under your guidance, the dynasty can recover from this blow and attain even greater power. I am impressed by your prudence, your decision to arrive on Footfall incognito, without announcing either the death of the previous rogue trader or your own status. It was quite wise. The rumors will spread sooner or later. It's impossible to keep secret something that's known to thousands of people serving on a void ship, but for now, you are free to reap the benefits of anonymity. As you may have noticed, Footfall is currently in a state of crisis. Its people would benefit from the patronage of a figure such as yourself.
I was attacked. Right at the docks. An outrageous stunt. A show of disrespect for both you and me. Sadly, such incidents on Footfall are akin to natural disasters. Impossible to predict or preempt. They simply happen.
Many consider Footfall to be a pirate den, but believe me when I say there's a difference between organized crime and gangs of thugs who have nothing to lose. You're attacked by the latter. The Anders are a gang of punks who spit on our customs and hierarchy. Even their noble leader is more akin to an ideologue, a rabble-rouser who calls for people's heads, not a commander. Sooner or later, we will find him and have him strung up. That will likely cool his followers' enthusiasm.
I can tell they've been a real pain for you. I bet you'd love to gut those jokers, wouldn't it? Come on, admit it, you would, wouldn't you?
Back where I grew up, they called throwing someone for a loop. They carve a particular sign on the person's forehead, then load them into a slag disposal chute, and send them out to orbit the station. Every 30 years, we clean the orbit
and count how many stiffs bearing the signs have been floating around. You have no idea how much I want to throw those little thugs through a loop for the good old days. So, what's the situation here? Sure. Troubling. Xenos raids are growing more frequent, trade is suffering, and fringe worlds are going under. Rumors of atrocities being committed by enemies of humanity are causing excessive panic due to their exotic nature. The core of the Imperium forces in the Coronis Expanse has departed for the sector's borders to combat the Xenos threat. There has been no word from them for a while now. Then again, with the distance and the current issues with the astropaths, that is not entirely out of the ordinary. Still, we are not alone. From several of the worlds hit by Xenos attacks, we have received reports of fierce warriors who descended from the sky and entered the fray. The fragmentary accounts lead me to believe that the Blessed Adeptus Astartes are operating in the Coronis Expanse, and await news of their victories with great anticipation. Any Xenos attacks on Footfall? No, there haven't. Attacking Footfall in general is not a particularly reasonable thing to do. Many ships are docked here at any given time, and even the listed weapons on board would make them a decent fighting force. And that's not to mention the power that our esteemed merchants have shamefully hidden from the station's customs officials. For us here, Xenos are more a source of income than a threat. We're talking about dealing in Xeno artifacts here, in a manner of speaking. Footfall is a place where anything can be bought, and, mind you, where anything can be sold. Naturally, I find this utterly unacceptable, and I have no desire to speak about this, but my Seneschal is a good listener. Lay your disgraceful gossip on him. I beg your pardon, Your Ladyship. It was important of me to offend your ears with such appalling words. So what sort of patronage is it that you seek from me? Protection. Not military protection, but a different kind of security. You have, of course, already encountered difficulties with the warp navigation on your way here. I'm afraid the scope of these difficulties extends beyond this area. Reports of disrupted routes and ships vanishing short jumps are coming in from across the entire sector. Communication with the Kalaxis sector has been extremely unstable. When the ships that have dived into the Maw in recent years, none have returned. The last ship that came through the Maw from the other side was struck by a temporal anomaly. The jump took almost 2 decades in real space-time. And this brings us to our main issue. Footfall is a repair shipyard and a training post. We barely produce anything ourselves and are largely dependent on incoming shipments, especially food shipments. The station, naturally, has some reserves, but the supply issues didn't start yesterday. Footfall would be obliged if House von Valencius would assist us by signing a contract for food deliveries. I'm not the only one you've asked for help. Naturally, I tried contacting other rogue traders, but the terms of House Corda would have bled Footfall dry, and for the esteemed Caligos Winterscale, instead of food shipments from him, I received a transport, the Navica, packed with refugees. I had sent them off to Foulstone. So many extra mouths to feed would have only worsened our crisis further. I suppose these warp fluctuations must have created more pressing matters for Lord Winterscale, so I put my faith in you, the third and last of Footfall's allies. So what are the terms? It's simple. Delivery of food shipments from your fertile worlds. Janus, I imagine. I'm quite familiar with that jewel of the von Valencius Protectorate. In exchange for fair payment. Oh, help, Footfall. I care about saving people's lives. Such charity is a rare sight in the Cronus Expanse. Even figures as powerful as rogue traders do not show it often. Thank you, Your Ladyship. So what have been the difficulties with the Anvers gang? Been using all my resources to delay the moment when my station is hit by famine. I haven't gotten around to the Anvers yet. As detrimental as they are, they know they're no players. When their leader dies, the rest will scatter. Alright, so where does one go to make a few deals? Here, yeah, I'm the main dealer on the station, and would be disrespectful of me to suggest you take your business to footfall traders of lesser importance. Still, you might take an interest in a few people of note. For example, the Reverend Hieronymus Deloroso, the servant of the Ecclesiarchy, is rumored to purchase sacred relics from captains, and other traders don't seem keen on becoming his competitors. If you're looking for goods that can entertain you, find Octaviana at the establishment called the Adeptus Amescus. The chemical bliss that she offers is refined and possesses a satisfactory degree of purity. Just don't ask her to pour you her signature drink. It's meant for common footfall rabble, not discerning clientele. Alright, so I've got some other questions about footfall. Rest assured, I will be candid, but my lips are bound by the oath of service. What exactly interests you on footfall, this abode of merchants, xenotechs, and traders, and only a few bandits? Actually, I have no more questions. So, let's take a look at your wares. Alright. And let's go ahead and trade. Orthlock pattern stub revolver. Yeah, I'll take those. Alright. Lord Captain, I am pleased to report that the inspections have been completed and all identified system failures have been resolved. The void ship is ready to depart footfall. Their crew is awaiting your further instructions, and there are a number of issues that need to be addressed.
How can one find the right way without his light?
Noble lady, a minute of your time, if you please. I am Bastion in Derma Basta Chorda, youngest cousin of House Chorda, envoy of the Insidia Basta Chorda, rogue trader of the Cronus Expanse by the grace of the Most Holy Emperor. And you must be the envoy of Theodora von Valencius, yes? I notice you arrived from your esteemed lady's ship. Chorda, they are some of the most influential rogue traders in the Cronus Expanse, but not on footfall. The station is under the control of House Winterscale. Something tells me we're about to hear a most curious offer. Quite right. I'm Lady Theodora's envoy. Splendid! It's a pleasure to be speaking with an equal. Truth be told, I get a little flustered in the presence of the powers that be. What do you wish to speak with me about? A matter of utmost delicacy. You see, you've been to the residence of the Liege. That aim almost certainly appealed to your assistance in the arrangement of shipments to footfall. The Von Valencius Protectorate is famed for the abundance of its main agri-world Janus. It would be odd for him to not seize on such an opportunity when footfall is on the verge of famine. However, the Court of Dynasty pursues its own interests on footfall. We have hardly announced our terms to Liege, but he is stalling. I imagine hopes of getting a better offer from you. The Court of Dynasty believes that cooperation would be preferable for both rogue trader houses. If you refuse Vladim, thereby forcing him to agree to deal with both of us, the Court of Dynasty can promise you a share of the profits from the future contract, as well as other perquisites. Everybody benefits. The Emperor's most loyal servants should be more concerned with carrying his will through the stars and less with divvying up profit amongst themselves, especially when the well-being of one of the Imperium worlds is at stake, even one such as Footfall. Behind your smile, Master Bastion, Teal's shadows swirl. Others may not see them, but worry cannot escape my eye. What are you afraid of? Your house's wrath should these negotiations fail? Or the wrath of House von Valencius? They're coming again. Brothers are the ones who came before. I don't get it. Do they all have a death wish? I appreciate the warning, Adira. What? I'll get help. Do you dare to look me in the eye? The Emperor is with us! Alright, let's start the battle. Twice dead Lanny. There we go. At your beck and call. Victory. And endure. I like this. Stun grenade.
Battlefields are always drowned in scarlet.
All right, let's now. Well, that was fun. Reload.
Emperor, give me strength.
Oops. Round two.
Gray hair, sure hair.
There we go. Yeah, let's do the heroic act.
And thy light I crave. I'll do it. Eradicate it. None can escape the Emperor's judgment. Faith without deeds is worthless. Each strike is a prayer. The Emperor commands, I act.
All right, Abelard, just go ahead and kill this guy.
I will do my one to a target.
Twice dead Lanny. Hopefully that's not Lanny Pator. Yeah, there's no reason to.
At your beck and call.
Step aside. The navigator is coming. Isn't this a job for the serfs?
Alright, let's just do this. All right, there.
It will be done. For von Valencius. Indeed. At your beck and call. An exemplary strike. It will be done.
There we go. Casing chest plate. Okay. Light. I see the light. I was blinded by the light. Lit up like a deuce in the middle of the night. Dreadful Xenos. Drokhari. Plunder to Xenos, a coin for a go. Yaldari. Come one, come all! See for yourself the best collection of lives in Osun Footfall. What kind of collection is this? Dangerous, vicious, ruthless Xenobeasts, caught red-handed as they were attempting to commit vile evil against the Imperium. But right now, they're getting harm. They're harmless. Our cages can withstand their rage, but I wouldn't recommend getting too close. These aren't Xenos. They're mutants in makeup. Not Xenos, you say? I'm sure there must be a mistake. I will check the shipping list myself, rest assured. His words are oozing with greenish-yellow hues. I do not think the promise will be kept. Such entertainment is lucrative precisely because billions of Imperium subjects have never encountered Xenos in their life. Ignorance and curiosity create a colossal demand. That's what I was taught, and I can see that lesson was truthful. Not by the captives. That can be done. Very much so. The entire collection will cost you a tidy sum, but you're free to take them right away, now. Portions look meager. Shopkeep. Just cut their throats already! What were they thinking about that ship dock at Footfall? They're all stricken!
No, no cutting. We'll get the blood on us and we'll be tainted too. Better burn them.
I pray for the rogue trader to receive a revelation from the Omnissiah. They'll let her find her place in the great mission. Quiet, you scoundrel. You dare pass judgment on others? What arrogance. You to think you have the right. That's Reverend Hieronymus. I'm surprised he decided to intervene in a street squabble. Alright, so what's going on here?
And who are you supposed to be?
I'm an envoy of the Von Valencius dynasty.
You come from Lady Theodora?
Pardon me, noble lady.
You're just rooting out heresy here. The scrawny ones, they're from the ship that came from the bowels of the Coronis Expanse. They've got plague there, and mutants, and now they're spreading that rot everywhere, and taint. They're all...
Silence! You must be completely out of your minds. A band of woefully dim-witted reprobates who think themselves bringers of justice. Who are you to pass judgment on anyone? All you ought to be doing is suffering and repenting till the end of your days.
And what's so wrong about that, Reverend? We just want to put these heretics to death.
We're not heretics! We're refugees! I swear on the Golden Throne! We served the Imperium faithfully until they hung us out to dry. Where were the protectors that were meant to shield the lands of humanity from nightmare? Traitors, traitors, and heretics, a lot of them!
How tiring. The motley sea of colors that fills the rest of the crowd is hard on the eyes. But so many hues. Most of them are acrid, acid yellow streaks of fear. Their red buds swelling, ready to burst and paint all the people who are gathered here.
Those are serious accusations you're spouting. I hope you have proof to back them up.
What more proof do I need? Kaiva Kami used to be a prosperous world. My family transported goods from there for generations, and when they came, they butchered, tortured, sacrificed entire blocks of darkness, ruined our ship in orbit, and all those messages started coming in. Half the Wardens down there joined them right away, and they even reached us in our ship with some blight that made our... half our crew take our own lives. We barely escaped. We barely made it here. Why? Why did this happen to us?
I wonder what all this is about. Is our planet really under attack, or did some devious opportunist send these slanderers here to undermine the might of the Von Valencius dynasty? I wonder who it could be. There's one guy, I bet you've heard of him. His name is Conrad Voigtver Von Valencius. He ran from us not too long ago, after having his ass handed to him. I bet he's itching to get even. Could even by besmirching the dynasty to which he belongs and supremacy over which he laid claim. He is scum, but he's no idiot. I think there is something else. There are many who wish to weaken House von Valencius. And that it's much simpler. These people aren't long and their planet was captured by heretics. And the rest of it, they made up themselves. I can sense darkness in their past. I may not be an expert in Coonrad's and other schemes, but when it comes to things like this, I know what I'm talking about. I represent the Von Valencius, masters of Chiave da Gama, and thus I have a right to decide what to do with these people. I command the onlookers to disperse. As for the rest of you, go to Dock Alpha Rho and await further instructions. What makes you think we'll listen to you? Maybe you're one of them, here to help your heretics buddies, huh? Sure, you say you're Von Valencius envoy, but Void knows if it's true. Just stay out of this. You too, priest. I hope you don't plan on letting those insults to your house slide. Absolutely not. You dare oppose me? Go on then. Wreak your depravity. The Emperor already sees all the rotten baseness that reigns in your souls. I place my hope in his judgment. Alright. Put that there. Pascal, go there. Two, three, four. Alright, and let's begin.
At your back and call. It will be done. Reduce to dust. At your back and call.
Yeah, let's do this.
No.
As the Emperor commands, I act. No. To cross my gaze.
Indeed.
All right.
Are always drowned in scarlet.
There we go. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I had a blocked passage. Logic. Ooh. Bastion Corda. Hieronymus. The Emperor protects. A holy man, are you? Here, some alms for you. I have no need for baubles. Play with them yourself if they bring you joy. Money can buy neither peace nor salvation. And you must be the young Von Valencius. That name carries weight, and it is a burdensome one, for its reputation suggests Theodore encumbered it with many transgression. I wonder, will you seek to shed them, or will you carry them forward, picking them along like ripe fruit, and savoring their sweet poison? I put my faith in the Emperor. Well then, be twice as diligent, for this sector will seize any chance to test your faith. Greetings, sister. I congratulate you on your return. Was your pilgrimage fruitful? It was, Reverend. Let it be known to you that Theodore von Valencius' ship was attacked by servants of the archenemy, who appall the heart of any righteous soul, and not all of them met a fitting end. Some fled, and more than that, their blasphemous words clearly pointed this attack as being part of a larger design. Reverend Hieronymus, I wish to join the esteemed rogue trader's crew and help protect the Von Valencius dynasty from the forces of the archenemy. I am divesting myself of responsibility of guarding the Footfall Reliquary. Sister Argenta stood by my side during the assault on the ship, and I could use her assistance going forward. Follow the call of your soul, sister. The Footfall Reliquary will be preserved even without your contribution, as it was in all the years preceding your arrival. I know what it is that calls you to follow the rogue trader, Sister Argenta. You seek combat, for it helps you forget how hollow and worthless our lives truly are. It offers the illusion of meaning. Perhaps you will relinquish this illusion one day,
or perhaps you'll die before that day comes. Regardless, I wish you luck on your new path. But before you start on the path towards your new destiny, I have a request to make of you and your companion. Many among my flock are the poorest, most disposed people of Footfall. They brought me troubling news from Footfall's Shadow Quarter. In the darkest corner where the liege's wardens do not venture, taint has taken root. Footfall is consumed by profanity, but even here, true heresy, serving the archenemy, is a rarity. The cultists now dwell in the Shadow Quarters, mark their abode with a sun inscribed in blue and gold, and perform strange rituals in secret. The weak find solace in believing these reports to be rumors. But I know well that evil lurks around us, and I wish to seek retribution. We will verify this rumor, Reverend Heronius, with pleasure! I almost wish the rumor to be true. My heart yearns to battle some heretics. This is where I bid you goodbye, sister, noble Priscilla. Is there any more you wish to talk to me about? No, I will take my leave. All right. In the name of the founder of Footfall Station, conqueror of stars, builder of outposts, the noble Sreg trader, Parsimius Duane, and on behalf of all his descendants, I welcome you. This conjugator was installed on the order of the illustrious Primaris, or Parsimius, so that the needy may tap into the flow of his wisdom. Cast your eyes upon the list of sections and choose what you wish to know. Parsimus Duane, I've never heard of such a rogue trader house. However this Parsimus was, he sure thought big. Lord Parsimus Duane, one of the trailblazers of the Crow's Expanse, and the station's founder. I've read about his great deeds, but by his will later inherited a warrant. He accumulated enough power to gather a small fleet of loyal allies to venture out and conquer the expanse. Alright. Let's go to the great Parsimus Duane intends to conquer the Cronus Expanse and build the most grandiose structure which will shine through the ages, praising the names of the Creator and his descendants. Footfall, the palace in the stars, the glory of the great Parsimus' deeds will live on throughout the ages, and his grand design intends to conquer. The spirit of this machine is enraged and will perform its function no more. I'll see to it that its profaners responsible for its maintenance are marked for servo penance. Lost information. To the rest of Footfall. Let's go here. Yes, it seems there are always some rumors out there. Rogue Trader, I would like to remind you about Reverend Hieronius' request. He asked us to search for a potential cultist in Footfall Shadow Quarters. You seem weighed down by something. What? No! Fudge, Rogue Trader. Being here on Footfall is rather difficult for me. It's a minor personal weakness, but I'm ready to fight as ever. Of no effect on my combat skills. If something is troubling you, tell me. Perhaps I can help. I suppose I could share it with you, but the tale would be long, and I will have to start from the beginning. I wasn't born in the Expanse, but I was sent here as a guardian of a reliquary on Footfall. My ship became caught in the warp anomaly, and although it lasted only days for those on board, decades had flown by in real space. When I last arrived on Footfall, it felt like I had been erased from time. No one was waiting for me on this side of the Maw. The people who were supposed to greet me, who knew about my imminent arrival, had died. The reliquary that should have been mine to safeguard had instead been taken under the protection of Reverend Hieronymus and his brethren. They were more than up to the task. They had no need of my help. Footfall became my cage. I didn't know who I was or what purpose I had here. The way back to Calaxis seemed like another trap. If I were to find a ship head that way, my sector, my order, they too would have lived decades without me by that point. Whenever I'm reminded of those months spent on Footfall, it feels like I'm falling into a pit. I hope the rumors of cultists turn out to be true. I can't wait to prove with my bolt of that the world and the Imperium need me. Alright, so what changed? A sign almost important showed me the right path, but not something I can speak of in the street. Let us be on our way. All I'll say is that on Footfall I met Lady Theodora and joined her, and that was the end of my languishing in this place. Alright, we must keep going. Alright, let's see. Elevator.
The sooner we start.
I think I have to activate that from down there. All right. All right.
I'll guide your vessel and lead you on your way.
The Martyr's Endurance.
Hmm.
Tech use? Let's see.
This exploratory is blessed with multifunctionality.
Let's check the logic here.
I just might. That's the second bottle you've downed.
Jai Hidari. Falco sends his regards.
And what does that unholy scion of a Grox and a Brahan want from me this time? Oh, wait, I don't really care. My sole plans for tonight are drowning my grief in a sea of Amasak.
Who'll give you grief, all right? Get out!
Don't think so, Ashma. And tell Falco to come himself next time.
All right.
Hidari, I am tired of your mess. Out. Get some sleep. We'll talk about settling up later.
Octi Sherin, light of my eyes. Can't you see my soul is full of sadness? Have you no horse at all? Let go of your material concerns and let me grieve in peace. Have we met somewhere before? Greetings, Sherin. With whom do I have the honor of speaking?
I am Priscilla, Trade Envoy of House von Valencius.
Well then, here's to our meeting. It doesn't take a genius to figure out that you're someone special, since you've been granted an audience with the Liege of Footfall himself. It's always a pleasure to make the acquaintance of someone powerful. And the timing couldn't be better. Jai Hidari at your service. Professional trader, shrewd commercial broker, and, may Ashi steal my tongue if I'm lying, the most honest dealer on Footfall. Nonetheless, we all have our problems, and at times even one's many merits aren't enough to solve them. Perhaps it would be no trouble for a person with your kind of power and standing to assist someone with my kind of predicament.
All right, continue, please.
I have heard a great deal about how open-minded the members of the von Valencius dynasty are, and Lady Theodora especially.
What kind of cargo is stolen from you?
Goods of incredible rarity, Sherin. But it's not just that. 2 dozen of my people lost their lives in the impenetrable emptiness of the void to acquire them. I cannot leave their families with nothing.
All right. Are you asking an upstanding citizen to be party of the trafficking of Xeno artifacts?
I thought we were on the same page from the start, Sherin. Please, if I had told you directly, you would have become, shall we say, complicit. But since those illicit words did not escape my lips, you would hypothetically be agreeing merely to help me recapture a few containers. And if the Aji suddenly decided to thwart our plans, then all the void dogs would be unleashed on me alone. My sincerest wish was to protect you from any unnecessary trouble, Sherin. I swear, by the Exalted One.
as many as you wish, Shireen. Trust is the key to a successful endeavor.
What do you need help with?
You see, Shireen, there's one cardinal rule on football. Anything goes as long as it doesn't get in the way of business. I'm someone who's been able to exploit that rule to the fullest. And in recent years, I've hit it so big, I've become a speck of sand in someone's green eye. They used to throw small wrenches into my dealings here and there. Well, now they've decided to really put their backs into it. Some rats stolen my cargo and dragged it off to the seediest part of the Shadow Quarters. A crummy place, even for connoisseurs of football's unique atmosphere.
All right.
When I asked the Leech for protection, we had a mutual misunderstanding. I believe Vladayim, in a most lamentable fashion, has forgotten his duties as guardian of the downtrodden and wronged. So I'm in desperate need of a new one. And you, Shireen, fit the bill perfectly. All I need is for you to drop by one dark corner of Football Shadow Quarters and pound it into the thieves' heads that taking Hedari's property carries certain risks.
If the Leech is neglecting his duties, I shall become your patron.
May the Exalted One bless you and your progeny. Then here's what we'll do. We shouldn't be seen together before we make it to the safe house. I'll head there first. I'll take my own special route so I won't be spotted. Right. Here. That's where those ashmags are keeping the stolen cargo. Out the bar, over the bridge, and to the left. There, in the depths, you'll find a small courtyard, through which you can get to the place. I'll be waiting nearby. You can come when it suits you, but the sooner you do, the better. I'll see you then, Shireen. Let's check this open door. Refugees, thugs. Oh, by the throne, that's him, isn't it? The poor sap who got his tongue cut out by the Anvers? That's the one. I think it was from Caspilica. Well, his troubles are over now. Duty prevails. Cast your eye there.
What's this? Ooh. Riza. Looking for something specific? Or maybe you're buying? Or maybe selling? Don't be shy, just ask. Old Rizzo knows all kinds of folks. My boys will fetch you anything your heart desires. I know you. Priscilla, who would have thought the high flyer such as yourself would ever land in our neck of the woods? The audacious schemes you've pulled off, they're the stuff of legend. Even the Caspilica could learn a thing or two. For someone like you, I'll only offer the best price as the real deal. Grandpa Bakval says hello. That old rascal! I thought he'd croaked in the mines a long time ago. But old man Bakval's still alive and kicking, you say? Me and him have been through a lot of scrapes together, and oh, all the weird and wonderful things we've acquired. Bakval wouldn't send his regards along with anyone. You must have done him a good turn, and because of that, old Riz is going to give you a special discount. What kind of goods are you willing to... Let's see what you have to offer. Alright. Full hammer I want to keep. I don't care about that. Improved auto pistol. And keep the Drakari stuff. Don't sell those. Biogel. Let's see. Show tradable. All right. I think I should talk to Octavia. Or Octavania. Argenta. No, no, you've picked up a lot of local knowledge. What do you know about the Anvers? All right. Yeah, that's how these things tend to go. So about the woman that started a gunfight at the bar? Alright, give me the latest. Okay. Interesting. Hey, Shalom. Have a good one, Senna. Thank you for popping in. And yeah, this game is fantastic. No.
Marching on.
All right, rest of the Shadow Quarters. That's a lot of people lined up.
Carry the Emperor's will as your torch.
Mastercrafted patella augment is not fit for a servitor.
My success is an irrefutable certainty.
There we go.
Heresy grows.
Alright, and here let's go ahead and use one of these. Pascal. Edge of Daybreak. This sounds like the Final Dawn. Oh.
Don't you dare to cross us.
You'll make a suitable sacrifice.
Cultist sorcerers. Really?
My ears are ringing.
Your faith shields me.
Okay. Let's put three exploits there. And now expose the weakness. Argentia.
It escaped the Emperor's judgment.
All right, anything else? No, it doesn't look like it. All right.
insist, Lord Captain.
All right, let's go here.
I've seen worse battles than this.
It's better be ineptitude, not malice.
At your beck and call.
Alright, that seems like a good place for me to be. Yeah, let's do a precise attack. Adira, let's see. Analyze enemies.
Will do.
And then let's let's go here and attack that.
Just as I foretold. Administration is a holy task.
All right.
Pain and duty go hand in hand.
Here. And give that to Abelard. Let's
indeed. It will be done. I will do my duty.
All right. Here, and stabby stabby. excuse me again. Really? Okay. Here. All right. Let's go here. Let's go there.
The enemies of the Emperor will be undone.
Your fortune has found
me. I will avenge you.
And you give that to you?
I'll
Let's go here. And then just hit you with that. There. Let's use that. Alright, Fasca, let's have you come here. And let's do a precise strike. On you. I don't have a Hydrate Redeem. And like I said, I'm going to put in an Anti-Hydrate Redeem when I get Affiliate. Alright, let's switch out to this. And then here.
Doubt is for the weak.
Now, I want to... Okay. There. Want to get rid of you.
It will be done. I took care of this one.
Alright. That's down. Coldest leader. Here. All right. Good night, Ketzer. Thank you for joining. Reload. Let's go over to here.
Tried and tested tactics are the best.
Precise attack. And then Machine Spirit Banishment. And let's... We'll go there.
God Emperor, move through me. Be the fire in my heart.
Mm-hmm. Alright, I want to do a real quick expose weakness. Okay, yeah, let's do this. This is incredibly close. What? What? All right, let's try some. Let's see. Let's do a precise attack. All right. Yeah, let's get rid of one. Never mind. All right. Analyze enemies, and now let's... remove those. Let's see. Whew. Blasphemous heretic, who you're praying to? I know those words that call to a... Of course you know them. I recognize you too, laggy of the corpse on a throne. Haven't you already experienced the power of the true god? Didn't you flee from us, shedding tears? I am one of the Adeptus Sororitas, and I have never, not once in my life, fled from heretics and betrayers of humankind. Can't you see he's trying to get under your skin? I bet he wants a quick bolt to the head instead of a bonfire. Smells of a dark future like an... noose around the neck. The heretic must be interrogated. What do you want to know, servants of the corpse emperor? The names of my brethren, how many of us there were, where we are? I'll tell you myself, we are myriad, we are everywhere. Soon, very soon, you'll hear our voices. And when you hear them at your back, so close you can feel our breath, then you'll know the power of a true god. Ooh. Who or what is this true god you keep mentioning? You'll know in time. All right, end him. Crippled leg, okay, broken ribs.
It is my destiny
All right. Come on, come on. I want to heal on my ship. Void Dock Alpha Rome. All right. To asynchronous communication. Discharge of contract. I don't want to go there. Is it this way? All right, Opticon 2020. I received an invitation to a meeting. You waited 30 years to pay up? What payment can I expect? I confirm that I'm willing to accept the payment. Let's make a trade deal. All right. Lord Captain? Our interrogator, what a surprise. Did you, perchance, leave something in your cabin? Not at all, First Officer Wurzon. I'm not in the habit of leaving a trail, but I thank you for your concern. To what do I owe the pleasure of this latest visit? Only to our mutual duty to humanity. It is that duty that demands that I disturb your peace once more. I was able to contact my mentor and report the tragic events that transpired on Rykad Minoris. I also received some information from my agents regarding the movement and actions of enemies of humanity, including the Xenos, that we're assuming were involved in the theft of the star. According to their findings, that threat now hangs over other worlds. This time, yours, Lord Captain. Great. What exactly caused this need? All right. Okay. Let's go back to the void ship bridge. Because now it is time to say goodnight. There is somebody that I need to check in on. So let's go ahead and raid her. Isn't that name just intriguing enough? Talk to you later. Bye.